大家好! Welcome to Learn Mandarin Chinese in 5 Minutes YouTube channel. Today we are breaking down a super common Chinese character, xia. In just 5 minutes, you will not only understand what it means, but also be able to use it in real-life sentences. Let's get started. Alright, let's take a quick look at this character, xia. This character is pronounced as xia, fourth tone, and the basic meaning is down or below. There are only 3 strokes, so it's super easy to write. Xia is used in so many everyday Chinese phrases. Let's check out some of the most useful ones. Whenever you hear 下雨了, you know it means it's raining. 雨 means rain. Super useful when talking about the weather. 下班. 下班 means to get off work. You can use this to talk about your day-to-day routine. For example, when your dad is back from work, you can say 爸爸下班回来了。爸爸下班回来了. When you want someone to sit, you can say 坐下 in Chinese. 坐 means to sit. 下 is down. So 坐下, sit down. Sentence example, 别玩了,坐下来休息。别玩了,坐下来休息. Stop playing, sit down and rest. Another super useful phrase to use and to remember is 一下. 一下 can be added after almost any verb to soften the tone or to indicate a brief action. It's a very versatile and polite way to speak in Chinese, especially in requests and invitations. Now let's take a look at a few examples that will make you sound like a native speaker. For example, 等一下, wait a moment. When you see someone leaving and you want this person to wait for you, you can say 等一下, 等一下. You are interested to buy a particular watch, but you do not know whether it's worth buying. So you can ask a friend to have a look. You can say, 帮我看一下这表. You are out shopping with a friend and you saw a dress that is rather suitable for her. So you can ask her to try. You can say, 去试一下. When you have a quick question to ask someone, you can say, 问一下. 我想问一下,请问一下. Another useful phrase is 下次. So when you are making plans, you can use 下次, next time. For example, 下次我请你去我家玩. 下次, next time. 我请你去我家玩. I'll invite you to my house to play. The next phrase we are looking at is 下楼. 楼 by itself means building that has more than one story or floor, so literally means down floor, but we don't say down floor, we say downstairs. Sentence example, 她匆忙地下楼, she hurriedly went downstairs. Do you like playing chess? Play chess in Chinese is 下棋. You cannot say 玩棋, although 玩 also means play in Chinese. Sentence example, 他和朋友在下棋. He's playing chess with a friend. If you want to say I like playing chess, you can say 我喜欢下棋. 下 can also be used to indicate location. For example, 下面 or just 下. Sentence example, 猫在桌子下 or 猫在桌子下面. The cat is under the table. Now it's time for you to practice. I'm going to say a few sentences using 下, and I want you to guess the meaning. 现在是下午两点. 下次再见。下次再见。小明在楼下。小明在楼下。请问一下。请问一下。Let us learn how to write the Chinese character 下 together. That is all we have for you today. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you never miss a lesson.